Good afternoon, dear children. Everybody doing well? Have you enjoyed holidays? Congratulations for all participants in the Kalolsavam. All events were beautifully presented by you. Okay. Today let us start 7th chapter, Ashoka who gave up war. We can see lions in our notes and coins, in our rupees. It is the lions in Ashoka Stamba. It is our national symbol. These lions were carved out from stone and placed on top of a massive stone pillar, a big stone pillar. It is in Saranath. Okay. Ashoka was one of the greatest rulers in India. In his period, many inscriptions were inscribed on pillars and rocks. Do you remember what is inscription? We already studied it in chapter 1. Now let us look why Ashoka's kingdom was called an empire. Ashoka's kingdom was called an empire. Why it is so? This empire was founded by his grandfather Chandragupta Maurya about 2300 years ago. Chanakya or Kaudilya was his advisor. Upadeshiyarayirunnu Chanakyan or Kaudilyan. Chanakya's ideas were written down in a book called Arthashastra. You can see a map in page number 68. There were several cities marked in that map in black dots. Pataliputra was the capital city. You can see it in that map. Then another city is Takshila and Ujjain. Takshila was the gateway to the northwest and central Asia. It is a gateway to the northwest and central Asia. Ujjain was on the way from north to south. North and south lekkulla vazhiyilulla oru city irunnu idu Ujjain. Merchants, officials and craft persons lived in these cities. Okay. In other areas there were villages. There farmers and herders lived. In some other areas such as central India there were forests. Here people gathered forest produce and hunted animals for food. People in different parts of the empire spoke different languages. They ate different kinds of food and wore different kinds of clothes. Okay. Next we can look how are empires different from kingdom. What is the difference between empire and kingdom? Empires are larger than kingdom. They need to be protected by big armies. Emperors need more resources than king. What is resources? Things. Emperors ne koodal vastukal venam. Endana valliyadana empire nanale. Idu full aayittu nokkan vendi ivarku endha oru baad resources venam. They need a large number of officials for collecting taxes. Okay. Next we can look how these empires are ruling. The empire was very big. It is very large. Different parts were ruled differently. The areas around Pataliputra was under the direct control of the emperor. The area around Pataliputra. What is Pataliputra? It was the capital city. So the area around Pataliputra was under the direct control of the emperor. Officials were appointed to collect taxes from farmers, herders, craft persons and traders who lived in villages and towns in the area. Officials also punished those who disobeyed the ruler's orders. These officials were given salaries. Messengers went here and there. Messengers, doodammare angottum ingottum ingane poikondirikkum. And spies. Spies also. Spies kept a watch on the officials. Charamar ennu parayile avaru. Spies kept a watch on the officials. The emperor supervised them all with the help of members of the royal family and senior ministers. With the help of members of the royal family and senior ministers, the emperor supervised all these officials. Okay. There were other areas or provinces. Each of these was ruled from the provincial capital. It was from Takshila or Ujjain. There was a control from the capital and the princes sent as governors. Besides, there were vast areas between these centers. Here the Mauryas tried to control roads and rivers which were important for transport and to collect whatever resources were available as taxes and tribute. For example, the Arthashastra tells that the northwest was important for blankets and South India for its gold and precious stones. It is possible that these resources were collected as tribute. Other vast areas in between the provinces and the capital cities. The Mauryas controlled roads and rivers and they collected taxes from these places. Okay. It is in the form of gold and precious stones. There were other areas. It was forested region. People living in these areas were independent. But they may have to provide elephants, timber, honey and wax to Mauryan officials. Okay, the people in forested regions have to provide elephants, timber, honey and wax to Mauryan officials for the kingdom. Okay. Today this is enough. Read textbook 2 times. Tomorrow you have a Zoom class. Before that, everybody study chapter 6 properly. I will ask questions. Okay, thank you.